I can't wait for you to taste today's tech news. It's an old family recipe.
The secret ingredient is Google.
Pushing clock speeds to ever higher heights has long been the province of desktop chips, but Intel is bringing CPUs with clock rates of up to 5 gigahertz not just to laptops, but to ultra portables. And I'm not talking about trendy tote bags. At Computex, Intel announced the Core i7-1195G7, rolls right off the tongue, which can hit the 5 GHz mark on one core at boost speeds. The new chip represents the top of an upcoming product stack, and the rest of the chips are nothing to sneeze at, with two other i7s topping out at 4.8 and 4.7 GHz. Of course, clock speeds aren't everything. Having a newer, more efficient microarchitecture that can execute more instructions per clock is typically more important, but it still represents a cool milestone for folks who mostly do their computing on the go. I just wouldn't try to strap a liquid cooler to your super thin laptop if 5 GHz still isn't good enough for you. What are you anyway? Just be happy. And there's more Intel news. Their lineup of next unit of computing, mini PCs, also known as NUCs, are usually made to be as small as possible, but Intel's latest offering is bucking that trend and sacrificing compactness in order to fit in a full-sized graphics card. This new powerful model needs an appropriately badass name, so Intel's calling it
Beast Canyon.
And yes, it's got Intel's backlit skull logo on the back too. Sure. You could give it to grandma, along with a free ticket to Headshot City. The new NUC is about the size of a toaster, thanks to the CPU and RAM being combined on an adapter called a compute element. And I think LTT actually reviewed the previous generation model, but that one didn't have any beast branding at all, so it loses points just for that. Chinese phone maker Xiaomi wants you to stop waiting around forever for your phone to charge. Although the company has made headlines in the past for their fast charging tech, their newest revision has reportedly broken the 10-minute barrier for fully charging a phone. Xiaomi says their new HyperCharge uses a 200-watt wired charger to bring a 4,000 mAh phone from 0 to 100% in just 8 minutes. And the wireless version is nothing to sneeze at either. I'm not sneezing at a lot of things on this script, hey? As that solution only takes 15 minutes. It isn't clear yet when HyperCharge could be broadly available, especially as it doesn't even appear to be in production yet, but hopefully it could save folks like myself who constantly forget to plug in their phones before bed. I don't forget, John. I purposely don't because it's bad for my battery. Now it's time for the quick bits, brought to you by Shells. Shells.com offers secure personal cloud computers that can be accessed from anywhere on almost any device. Shells runs in your web browser, so it works on your phone, your computer, or even your Tesla's dash. Really? Open a brand new high-speed computer in under 5 minutes with options for both Windows and various Linux systems. There's no hidden fees. Pricing starts at only $4.95 a month. That's less than $5, baby. So give your computer a break and get a virtual desktop at the link below. Shells. And now, the quick bits. As impressive as Microsoft's newest entry in the Flight Simulator series is, all that scenery has made it a very large game, but Microsoft has fortunately cut the size of the game roughly in half to 83 gigabytes from a whopping 170. Microsoft didn't say much about how they pulled this off other than talking about optimization. Maybe they just asked Clippy for help. Hey, got him. It's the end of an era for LG, as a report indicates the last ever LG smartphone has rolled off the assembly line and into the trash. Just kidding, but eventually. LG had already announced earlier this year that it was pulling out of the smartphone business, so this doesn't really come as a surprise to anyone. Really, no one. Existing phones will still be supported for a few years, with its smartphone factory in Vietnam to be converted into an appliance manufacturing facility instead. So we'll still have LG touchscreens, they'll just be attached to refrigerators for no reason. Twitter made headlines last week for reopening its blue checkmark verification process. Yeah, check out Carpool Critics. We're gonna get one. It's a movie podcast. But it's already on pause again because the site has been overloaded with so many requests. It promised to open requests again soon, though the last time this happened, they stopped accepting requests for 4 years. So maybe don't hold your breath. Fitbit owners may have a new feature coming their way. The fitness tracker has kept tabs on your sleep for a long time now, but a report indicates that a snore tracker may be released soon. Unsurprisingly, it probably won't be smart enough to tell the difference between you and your partner snoring, so at least people who live alone have something to be happy about. Hey, or separate beds, it's not weird. And do you remember how Denon and Marantz had that issue with HDMI 2.1 on their receivers where they wouldn't work with the new Xbox's 4K 120 FPS output? That was fixed with a free adapter, but now they're trying to offer HDMI 2.1 on their older receivers through a $600 add-in card. To be fair, they're targeted at top-end enthusiast equipment that already costs over $4,000, but still, $600 seems a little steep for just a port. Can you really put a price on your games being slightly smoother though? Oh wait, half of eBay already has. And that's our show. Come back on Wednesday for more tech news. We'd never try to resell for double the cost. Unless it somehow hurt the hedge fund people or something.